1968 Ford Mustang. Do a quick walk around. There's a replacement fender on the right front. Dual exhaust. I'll show you the problems first. Some frame damage here. This piece needs to be replaced. It's a $100 part. And new rocker panel. So the door will line up. Close is okay now. So some rust both sides. You can see here where the door should be. Interior is really nice. Upholstery. You see its latch is broken. This needs to be reconnected to the rod so it'll come back. All the windows work. It's got old speakers in the back. Headliner, very nice. Sun visors too, very good shape, very tight. It's got a new rear view mirror. Refurbished AM radio. Missing the rest of the trim on this side. I have the glove box. Brand new heater box. New core. New resistor. Everything new. New motor. Brand new American Auto Wire wiring kit. You can see down here, fuse box. These are just, these wires are just extra, just need to be tucked away. T5, 5-speed, short shifter with the 68 shift lever. The emblem popped off, I have that, just gotta glue it back on. There's the ashtray. Have the ashtray, cigarette lighter, new parking brake handle. This car was originally inline six automatic, converted it to V8 manual. Let's go around the other side. Wood dash. Got the heater controls there. Real nice gauges. Let's see, oil pressure, gasoline, engine temperature, coolant, tachometer, 120. Tripometer gauge. Both these gauges were refinished, so they look brand new.
See right here, 223 miles since the rebuild engine was put in. Had the guy reset the tack to the original mileage, so there's no problem with getting it registered. This car didn't have the tripometer originally, so that was an upgrade. Works good. I don't want to reset it, just because it's shown me how many miles since the rebuild. Tachometer was upgraded, new electronics, shows you the last RPM before the engine's turned off. So if you want to reset that, just turn power on, goes back to zero. Don't have the radio hooked up, no speaker. Yeah, no speaker right now. Works though. Working radio. See the floors. Not too bad. No rust on this side. Again, you can see here, you can see outside the car because of that one panel needs to be replaced with the new rocker panel. Door lines up perfect. It's just the body. Body's not right. So that piece will, it's right behind here, and it will push the where the door mounts out a little bit, push the body out and up. So it'll close perfectly then. Dash is in real nice shape. Got this carpet piece on there. No cracks at all. Might be a replacement. I don't think so. I looked under there. It looks OEM. Real nice. Driver's side floor. That's where the problem is. So you got rust right here. Came through the floor all the way through. See? So this will have to be patched out. Not too bad though. That's the only spot on the car. Rust ate through. See the back seat on this side. Nice interior. No problems with the interior. Just need to get some new speakers back here. But new window handles. That's not the right one. But real nice interior. Needs new carpet, obviously. Haven't torn up the back carpet yet, but you can see from the bottom of the car there's no rust problems. This right here, you can see before I even took the carpet out. You know. Doors are in good shape. All original factory tinted window glass. It's got the turn signal hood. So in there, see right there, right there. You got little lights light up when you have your turn signals on. The trim piece goes around the edge of the grill. I have that, it's just not installed. These are original 63 marked. You can see there. Those are real black and yellow California plates. Killer 68, kind of cool. They need to be, this front one especially needs to be redone. Needs to be restored a little bit, but that's a real rare piece. Let's open the hood. 302. Lots of new stuff on this car. So points, distributor, Got a 500 CFM brand new Edelbrock carburetor. Edelbrock Performer intake. Got some new reproduction valve covers on there. New air cleaner. Stainless steel full length headers to a free flow two and a quarter exhaust system. Brand new solenoid. Battery's about a year old, maybe, not even. New GM alternator. New water pump. Let's see, new coil. This is a new old stock power steering pump. That's kind of cool. It's got the correct color on there. It's kind of hard to find. We have a rebuilt master cylinder, all new stainless steel brake tubes all the way around. Stainless steel fuel line. You can see down there, it's got a manual. Here's it right there. Manual linkage for the clutch. Fully adjustable if you want it. There's the fuel lines. Rebuilt steering box. Short ratio. There's the carburetor. Real nice. Let's see. Got a big block aluminum radiator, aluminum shroud, and two electric fans. Got them set up on this relay here. So they'll either turn on when the engine gets to, I think it's 180, something like that, 190. And or you can flip them on manually, or just turn the fan off if you want to. So, let's see. Got Coney adjustable shocks up front and Edelbrock IAS on the back. Brand new progressive rate springs. These are just cheap wheels, but they are actually lightweight steel racing wheels. Dual exhaust. Here you can see the rebuilt rear end, 355 ratio. It's got cherry bomb vortex mufflers. Real nice in here, not too bad. It's got drive shaft, shortened drive shaft, have a 67 Fairlane. New springs. New springs all around. It's got a stainless steel fuel tank, 22 gallon. Get up front here. A little dirty. It's got new lower arms, all new ball joints, new rubber all the way around. That went with rubber bushings all the way around. It's got a see right there, Trans Am bar connects the two lower arms together. Upper arms rebuilt,
they're not new, but I rebuilt the bushings. 10 and 3/4 drum brakes up front, 10 inch brakes in the back, drum brakes. A nice beefy sway bar here. I believe that's 1 1/8. Yeah, everything's rebuilt. Everything rebuilt. A little dirty here. Yep. Brand new, these things. I forget what those are called. Torsion bars. All new motor mounts. New transmission mount. Like I said, it's got a T5. 80s Mustang T5 V8 version. It's kind of tall gearing, so you shift a lot. Works good though. So, there's the exhaust system. Fuel pump. Yep, that's about it. There's the new heater motor. Also has a power steering cooler that goes in line with the power steering pump. All right, let's start it up. Doesn't like to start cold, so I started it earlier. Should start right up. To idle about 500-600. Here we got good oil pressure. Gas gauge works. Let them get up to speed here. Temperature gauge works. The radio again. I thought that was working. Yeah. Oh, there you go. You hear it a little bit. It's just static. No antenna. I think that's the problem. No antenna. Oh, it sounds great. Those mufflers. Forgot to mention the steering wheel. This is a original. It's real wood grain. Steering wheel there, 1968 only, with this piece here. That's another, this is not a repro, this is a real piece. These little bits in here are in the trim, but that's a real one. Looks good, just a little tiny wear right there, that's about it. It's got a crack, been repaired, holds up good, haven't had any problems. Real hard to find these real ones. So, lucky to get one even with the crack. Looks good. See out here? No smoke. It's just cold today. Rebuilt 302. Alright. You can see right there, gauge stays at the last spot it was at. Here's the choke. Couple extra cables here. This all goes under the carpet and behind the rocker panels. Also have some. The car came with rocker or side covers there. For you know, to put a speaker in. So those come with the car too. See here, the switch controls your fan, so that's automatic. Turn on, you know, 190, whatever. I believe it's 190. That'll turn your fan off, and that'll turn it on. That'll override. Turn it on no matter what. It'll work. These are all hooked up. Lights work. Let's see if you can see that. LEDs in there. So the whole dash has LEDs, so it's real bright at night. Show you real quick, headlights. Lights. Tail lights. Has to be on. There we go. Left turn signal. Down there. Missing these side markers. I do not have those. I have the bracket for them. Right signal. There you go. That's it. Everything's been rebuilt. Head high beam switch. There is your windshield washer sprayer. So you push that with your foot to spray, you know, window cleaner on the windshield. 68 only. Only year they did that on the Mustangs. All new, you know, new insulation there on the firewall. Reinforced clutch. Everything's new. All new gaskets on all the openings on the firewall. Everything's been sealed up. New vent. Brand new vent. If you can see that. New parking brake cable. All the way to the back. New emergency brake cables. Everything new. New brakes. Both doors close real good. Let's see what else we can see. Is that fuel line? New stainless steel fuel line there. All the way to the tank. Vortex mufflers, parking brake cable, and that fuel line. Let's see if we can get the transmission in there. Is that 2.5 up in there. New speedometer cable, new gears, all that. There you go.